Lord God, we thank you once again, praising you, worshiping you, honoring you, glorifying you, extolling you, lifting you up, magnifying you, bowing before you, oh God. We recognize your sovereignty and your power. You are God. There is none like you, and there is none beside you. We will open wide our mouths, and we will bless your name, thanking you so much that you would even give us an audience. Your word says you delight to be with us. You look forward to seeing us. You wait daily at the gate for us to come. And so we just bless your name for that. Again, we welcome your angels into this place, God. We welcome your Holy Spirit. Have rule and have reign in this place. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen, miraculous. Welcome this morning. It is an amazing morning. I thank God for Jesus this morning.
Amen.
This morning. All right. So I want to say welcome, welcome, welcome all those who are on Facebook and who are on Zoom. We appreciate you being here, joining your prayers, your praise, your worship with ours. Our service is different because you are here with us today. So just want to welcome you and say thank you so much for stopping by this morning. And next we have our Through the Bible exegetical scripture. I'm going to now fasten your seatbelt and expect a move of God suddenly. Deuteronomy 11:21. If a believer honors God with a heart to live according to the word, he says that your days may be multiplied and the days of your children in the land which the Lord swore unto your fathers to give them, as the days of heaven upon the earth. God's plan is that his children begin to experience the inheritance of the heavenly life while here on the earth.
We are already his children,
and we have been given special rights.
Learning to walk in the word of God brings the benefits of the word of God into living, functioning reality.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Let your neighbor know he's all right. And if you have your Bibles, I want you to go to the book of Psalms, the 137th chapter. Amen. Amen. And when you see it, let's read the first four chapters together. Amen. And we start, said, by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, we wept, and we remembered Zion. Number two says, we hanged our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. Three says, for they were carried away captives, required, for they that carried us away captives required of us a song, and they wasted. Well, you get back up. Did I mess up? And they wasted us, and they that wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion. And number four says, how shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? You may be seated, amen. I'd like to talk to you today just for a few minutes. The thrill is gone. The thrill is gone, amen? As I begin to look in the dictionary, they say a thrill is a compulsory that makes you feel good, maybe even for 30 seconds, but it's a thrill, amen? It says a thrill will make you feel excited for a short time, amen? But we here dealing with the Bible today, and we find out that the Israelites were brought to a distant land, amen? They wasn't brought on their own, amen, but they were taken captive out of their country by the Babylonians. And they asked the song. They said, I want you to sing us some verse, sing us some songs. And they didn't know how to sing a song because they said, how can I sing a song? How can I praise God and I'm in a bad situation? Amen. Doesn't that sound like some of us? I look at some of the rappers, amen, and they tell them, say, sing us a song. And they'll sing a song calling they women B's and all that and H's and all that kind of stuff. It didn't just start then, and it ain't stopped, amen. And when they sang, what gets me when they sang that song, Sister Marv, what to do when they sang that song, they'll get up to the Grammys and say, I want to thank God for all he did for me. God ain't in that mess, amen. You try to give God the glory, talking about shooting somebody, killing somebody, talking about your woman calling her bees and holes and whatever else they call them. And then you get up there and say, I thank God, my almighty God. Well, what God are you serving? That's why Jesus said, many gonna call my name, amen. And when you call my name, I'm saying, I don't even know who you're talking to. I don't even know you, amen. But the three of them, you used to be in love with your mate, amen. You was thrilled to see her when she came home, amen. And even if she couldn't cook, the food tastes good anyhow. Even if you didn't like football, just because he liked you, were thrilled with it. So you'd watch football with him. That's when you got a thrill, amen. Even when his breath stank, and you said, honey, let me have a kiss. You went through all that bad breath because you had a thrill. And I get a witness now. But B.B. King said the thrill is gone. He said, you've been gone too long. You haven't did nothing good for me in a little while. And since you haven't did anything good for me, my thrill is gone. Now. When you first got her, you talked to her on the phone all night long. Can I get a witness now? And now that you got her, you tell her, baby, I'm trying to watch my TV program. That means the thrill is gone. Can I get a witness now? Fellas, you used to didn't look at nobody but her. But now the thrill is gone. And so when Sister Molly or Sister Sweatshirt walk by, your eyes begin to gaze at another woman. And you say, it ain't no problem looking. But I want you to tell you the thrill is gone. Can I get a witness now? They tell me that when you used to cook, and you know she couldn't cook when you got her, but you were so thrilled to have her, and now you tell her, I wish you cooked like my mama. The thrill is gone, Brother Andy. Good God Almighty. You see, when the thrill is gone, you don't even like the way she chew her food, amen. When the thrill is gone, he snored too much at night. Can I get a witness now? Something about a thrill only lasts a short time. But love, I don't want to be thrilled about you, baby. I want to be in love with you, amen. If I'm thrilled with you, it'll last a little while. If I'm thrilled about you, when you gain a few extra pounds, I'm going to lose that thrill. If I'm thrilled about you, when you get a little older, I'm going to stop being excited about you. It's something about a thrill, and it's something about love. Can I get a witness now? A thrill will take you only so far. And later on, you might wind up in divorce court. Can I get a witness now? But just like the man said, the thrill is gone. Or in a new country, not on their own admonition, but they're in a new country because they were brought by against their own will. And now they're asking them, I want you to sing us a song. I want you to sing like the song over there in Israel. Some of us, I know. When we get to a certain point, you may not say it. Everybody not like Job. Everything that Job went through, he said, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. He said, blessed be the name of the Lord. Some of us, we in love with Jesus. Till we get to the cemetery and look like Jesus, if you had been here, my mama wouldn't have died. If you had been here, my wife wouldn't have died. If you had been here, things would have been all right. Better get a witness now. But Jesus, oh Jesus, I stopped by to tell you, no matter what I'm going through, I'm not going to lose that thrill I got for Jesus. It's not a 90-second thrill. It's not a 60-minute thrill. It's not a one-day thrill. But oh my, he died. Good God Almighty. Some of us, we've been to the mountaintop and we're sliding down on the mountain now. We're not at the top no more. And we're wondering what happened with Jesus. Jesus is a way maker even in the valley. Jesus is a way maker even with tears in your eyes. My book says he counts every tear that came down, it said the tears of the saints are precious in the sight of the Lord. Can I get a witness now? Every time you cry, Sister Lillian, every time he's counting, every tear that comes down your eye, every stress, and we're stressed in this whole world, he's counting all the stress that you got. Can I get a witness now? Good God Almighty. I'm so glad. I understand now how the saints of old used to say, I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. Glory, hallelujah. He lifted me. You've been with me for 30 years. You ain't never worried about my snoring. But all of a sudden, I snore too much. The thrill is gone. Somebody say, if you loved me yesterday with that snoring, you ought to love me today with that snoring. But God Almighty, some of us, we're going to the church house. We say the choir sang too much. But I remember when you used to stay all day long. I remember when you didn't want to leave church. But the thrill is gone. The thrill, good God Almighty. Some of you out there watching us on Zoom, I remember you used to be at church every Sunday morning, but now you stay at home, drink your coffee,
But the Bible says, forget not to assemble yourself together. Maybe I see you on Zoom, but God Almighty, let me refocus that. You see me on Zoom, but I don't see you. You see me on Facebook, but I don't see you. Sister Cassandra, she's a 49er fan. The 49ers lost. When they lost last year, they say, if I had been in the right spot, if I would have been there where the 49ers was, in my own piece, they would have won. They would have won that game. Well, baby, I stopped by to tell you, if you come to church, we can score a touchdown. If you come to church, we can hit a home run. No, just because you ain't here, I ain't preaching like I should be preaching. But overall, if you come in the building, you ought to see Simon preach with a crowd, amen. You ought to see him. He might do the moonwalk, might step and go to another heaven, but I need you. You need me. And we all need to do that. The field is gone. The field is gone. It's raining. I can't come to church. It's cold. I can't come to church. Whatever it is, I can't make it there. It's because your field is gone. I can praise God right here at my house. Stop by to tell you, even Elon Musk say, ain't no more homework. You coming to the work tonight. You're going to do some overtime. You're not going to sit at home. You're not going to drink coffee while you're working for me. God Almighty. If Elon Musk got that much sense, what about Jesus, my mind regulator? Jesus, my heart fixer. Jesus, my soul satisfier. Good God. Baby. Somebody said, the thrill ain't gone with me. Wave your hand, the thrill ain't gone with me. I got a feeling, somebody listening to this message, they won't be on Zoom next Sunday. Can I get a witness now? Somebody listen to this message, they won't be on Facebook. Every now and then, I'll say a wrong word. Every now and then, I'll use a mispronunciation. The reason why I do that, because when you leave here, you're not going to remember nothing what I said, but you're going to remember when I made that mistake. Good God Almighty. What did the pastor talk about? Mispronunciation. They couldn't sing this song because they was in a bad place. They couldn't sing this song because they didn't see their temple no more. They couldn't sing this song because all the folks that they knew wasn't around no more. They couldn't sing this song because they was in bondage. And they said they laid their hearts against the wall. Some of us, I ain't talking about you folks that are here today. I'm talking about the Zoom folks now. I'm talking about the Facebook folks. God Almighty. Look a here. Bitch, you go. Bitch, this thing. You go everywhere else. Good God Almighty. But somehow, you can't make it to the church house. You go to parties, You go to football games. You go to basketball games. Don't worry about getting sick. Don't worry about no COVID. Ain't nobody wearing no mask. But when you get to the church house, I don't know. The church is a saving place. The church is the holy place. The church is the healing place. You ain't getting no healing at no basketball game. You ain't getting no healing at no football game. Healing at no picnic. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I was sick on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. But good God Almighty, I knew that if I make it to the church house, somebody said, make it to the church house. If I can just make it to the church house. If I could just get to the altar, I know everything will be all right.
Oh, he's all right. I'm thrilled with Jesus. I'm in love with Jesus, amen. Because he died. Somebody said that I shouldn't have been saved. But I think Jesus had more sense than you had, amen. He thought to let blood come out of his side. He thought to let blood come out of his hands. Somebody said, you need to quit all that foolishness. Saying we wasn't worth it. But he did it anyhow. Do you think Jesus is some kind of fool? You were worth it? Oh, yes, you were. I don't care how dirty you were, how nasty you were. There was some blood that came down Calvary. He thought, the Bible says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He didn't just die for the black man. He didn't die for the white man. He didn't die for the Asian man, but he died. He died. He died that I could have some good sense today. He died so I wouldn't be locked in hell. He died that mercy and justice look at each other and begin to kiss one another. That's how he died. Some of you have lost your thrill, amen. It's time to get your thrill back, amen. There was a song used to say, come to Jesus, amen. They come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. And they used to sing that, and the saints would say, I want to come back home, amen. You know what kind of experience I'm looking for at the church? I'm looking for a color purple experience, amen. Remember what that song should say? God's going, what? God trying to tell me something. Well, I want you to know he's talking right now, amen. Somebody ought to tell your neighbor, you should have been there, amen. Bishop say, if you guys fill the place up, he might walk on water. I need everybody here, amen. If you had been at that football game, the 49ers would have won. If they hadn't been bothering Brother Jamal that day, the Cowboys would have won that game. But you guys put a jinx on him or something. I don't. But what I'm trying to tell you is that we need you here, amen. We need you, amen. We need you, I need you, and you need me, amen. But most of all, God needs you, amen. He didn't die for nothing, amen. Somebody say, I'm not going to let my Jesus die in vain, amen. Everyone who go to hell, he died in vain, amen. Everyone who go, but I want you to know, he's not going to die in vain on me because I'm on my way to heaven, amen. I'm on my way to
be with Jesus, amen. Somebody say, I want to be with Jesus, amen. I want to be with Jesus. Come on up, choir. I want to be with Jesus. They say he's a mind regulator. They say he's a heart fixer. They say he's a soul satisfier. They call him Yahweh. They call him Jehovah Tiskanu. They call him Jehovah Jireh. I want to be with Jesus. I begin to think about the different things that happened in my life. And nobody could have brought me through but Jesus. Amen. I used to holler that he was a mind regulator, Brother Derek. But I didn't know until he regulated my mind. Amen. Sister Letha, I didn't know he was a heart fixer until he fixed my heart. Brother Carl, I didn't know he was a battle accident, time of trouble until I got in trouble. Amen. I didn't know he was a rose of Sharon until I began to smell how sweet he is. Amen. Oh, yes, he's all right. He's all right. This is your time. Facebook members, I know you're on your way to church, amen. You have to come next Sunday, amen, because we're getting out of here after a while, amen. But we're trying to tell you the thrill is right here, 2723 San Pablo Avenue, amen. The thrill, the more you come, the better it gets, amen. You go to the movie, because there's a lot of folks at the movie. But I want you to know, I ain't scared of no COVID. But I'm scared of, COVID can't do nothing but take your life and stuff. But I'm scared of God, amen. God can take your soul, amen. So don't tell me about the church ain't safe. No, Safeway wasn't safe either, but you went there. You stayed in alone. Nobody have a mask on. I know some folks who had COVID and went on a trip to a foreign country just a couple of weeks ago. So you don't know who you fooled with, amen? But God's house, amen? He'll make a way. I don't know. Somebody wave your hand and say, he made a way for me. He made a way for me. He made a way for me. The choir can sing because he made a way. Out of no way. Go ahead, Brian. Don't forget to take your test before you leave, amen. Don't forget to take your test before you leave, amen. We trying to help the youth, amen. Thank you.
Our rescue, praise is our help, praise is our strength. The joy of the Lord is our strength. When we rejoice in God, even out of the hard places, just like the message preached, you know, how can we sing songs of Zion living in a strange land? We have to learn how to praise God out of even some of the most difficult situations and know that he hears us and he will deliver. God is a deliverer. God is who he says he is. I am that I am. I am whatever you need me to be, when you need me to be that, how you need me to be that. Amen. Amen. I thank God for Jesus. I thank God for life today. I thank God for life today. Some folks are not having a life today. I think about the folks in Virginia who the young man got on the bus and killed those three guys and injured the other two. And apparently this guy was being bullied and misused and mishandled. We kind of talked about that in Sunday school this morning, where you're not supposed to curse the hard of hearing or put stumbling blocks in front of the blind or harass those that we perceive to be weaker or lesser than ourselves. People don't have the capacity always to handle that, and they let it out in whatever the only way that they see fit. So I pray for those families who have lost their children, who have lost their sons. I think about that. I have some of those. I have a couple of sons, and it kind of grips you when you hear about that loss. I could not imagine what that must be like. And so I pray for those people. But even out of that place, we worship God, regardless of what is going on in the world, the turmoil, the difficulty. You know, people are living any and every kind of way and calling it right. God is still on the throne. Make no mistake, there is nothing catching God off guard. He already saw this. He already perceived it. He's already made provision for his people. Amen. Amen. I thank God. All right. So it is offering time, miraculous. Offering is merely an extension of our praise. So you can clap your hands and say hallelujah and thank God. As a part of our offering, we also pay our tithe. Paying your tithes is a 10% of your increase. It is a 10th of your increase, and it is a regular payment that we make as we increase. Amen. Sometimes it gets difficult to do, but we do it anyway. It is an act. Paying your tithes is an act of not just obedience, but showing your trust in God. God, I trust you to make the provisions that I need. I trust you to make the provisions that I need. And make no mistake, miraculous. When you do not pay your tithe, I promise you, the Bible says that he will sew up, you know, kind of sew up the holes in your pocket. What the canker worm has destroyed, God will restore if we are faithful in our giving. We give for the furtherance of the kingdom of God so that the work of the church can move forward. When you don't give, you start to see it. You start to bleed money, as it were. And it's not just in money, it's in other areas of your life, because not paying your tithes is an act of disobedience. And every act of disobedience must be dealt with. So you might see it in other areas of your life. You might not be as healthy as you normally you are. Your businesses might not be going the way you would like them to go. On your job, things may not be functioning properly. I am saying to you, trust God in giving your tithe, in paying your tithe, which is the 10% of what you earn. You make $8,000, that's $800 that goes to God. You got a whole, what, $7,200 left to do with, not as you please, but to be a good steward over, right? God teaches us how to be a good steward, paying your tithes, giving your offering, your free will offering, which are two separate things, by the way. Giving your free will offering is God's financial plan for his people. If those who are givers will gain. Givers will gain. Amen. So I just want to encourage everybody, whatever you have to give, make sure it's a 10th of your increase. Amen. This is your opportunity to be obedient, to uncurse your money, by paying your tithes and giving your offering. We have receptacles on either side of the church. We also have our contactless method, mail, Zelle, PayPal, and Cash App for you to give. Make no mistake, that money is being monitored. You will get your tax receipt at the end of the year. So please feel free to give in this moment. Amen. All right. Lord God, we thank you. And we praise you, God, for money to give. Thanking you for income. Thanking you for provision. Thanking you, God, that we will not live in lack, but we will live in abundance. According to your word, says that you will open up the windows of heaven and that you will pour out blessings, so much so that we do not have enough room to receive, that you will give it in good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give unto our bosom. You have also said that the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just, that the earth is yours and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein, that you have cattle on 1,000 hills. All the riches of the world belong to you. God, we say thank you, because we are heirs and joint heirs to the throne of God. We have the privilege of calling you Abba, Father, and expect that if we ask you for a fish, you would not give us a serpent. So we bless you, God. We honor you, and we trust you for every provision. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay. So So at that time, if I'll ask you to stand as we prepare to leave and go our separate ways. But first, we'll hear a word from the Lord. This comes from John. And if you have a Bible and you want to mark it, you can go to John, the 13th chapter, and it's going to be the 34th and the 35th verse. This is a word from God. As I prepare to read John 13, the 34th and 35th chapter, let's go right to the word. A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another, as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love one to another. That's from God. That's the commandment he's given you. He's given it to each and every one of us to show love to the next person. That's the word from God. So with our heads bowed and eyes closed, Father, we thank you for this day given us. Father, we thank you for the loved ones that we see. Father, we thank you for the loved ones we don't see. Father, we ask that you be with each and every one of us as we go our separate ways. And Father, we ask that you look on those who are less fortunate. Stop by the convalescent home. Touch the old mothers and the old fathers. Stop by the prisons. Touch our sons and daughters. Touch only like you can, Father. Now, Father, as we go, oh, be with us. Bring us back once more and again. And Father, we say thank you for the days coming that we can say thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you're doing. And thank you for what you're going to do. This is what we ask. We say thank you, Father, for all you've done, given us life.
Thank you, Lord.
As I depart, just want to say thank you, Father, for the opportunity to share your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Amen.